हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज शेफाली राहुल गुटके, करंटली वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, एक्रेडिटेड विद नैक ए प्लस ग्रेड. आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर टूडेज जियो टेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग वन लेक्चर. इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट क्विक सैंड कंडीशन फेनोमेना. So basically, quicksand condition, it is not a type of a soil. Quicksand is a condition of a flow in which a vertical upward seepage flow causes the floating condition of a various particle which present in the cohesionless soil such as sand and fine gravels. When a flow takes place in an upward direction, in that condition, the seepage pressure also acts in upward direction. Hence, the effective stresses will get reduced to zero. In such cases, the cohesionless soil mass loses all its shear strength and bearing capacity. This phenomena in which the soil leaves the soil mass and flows along with the water is termed as quicksand piping, sand boiling, or floating. It means quicksand condition, also called as piping, sand boiling, or the floating condition of a soil. In such cases, the cohesionless soil lose all of their shear strength and the bearing capacity, and a visible agitation of a soil grains is observed. As you can see in this picture, the soil masses, the soil particles flows along with the water. So basically, this phenomena is called as quicksand condition. When quicksand condition occurs, when the seepage flow takes place in an upward direction, so in that condition, the seepage pressure also acts in upward direction and the effective pressure will get reduced. As we know, because of the submerged weight of a soil, there is a presence of a pressure which acts in downward direction. So, if the seepage pressure becomes equal to the pressure which is created due to the submerged weight of a soil, the effective pressure is reduced to zero. So basically, in that condition, when the effective stresses reduces to zero, the quicksand condition occurs. Okay. So the water surface is container B. As you can see in this picture, this is container A and this is container B. The water surface in the container B is cup above that of a A by H unit. It means the height of a water which is kept in B is greater than that of A. In A container, there is a presence of a soil mass and a presence of a water. Okay, because of this hydraulic gradient. As we know, hydraulic gradient is nothing but it is the ratio of head loss to the length of a soil sample. So because of the hydraulic gradient, the water flows from one side to another. Okay. So basically, this type of arrangement permits the water flow upward through the sample in a container A. The total piezometric or the pore water head at the bottom of a sample is given by. Basically, what we will do, we will insert here some piezometer. We will insert some piezometer to calculate the water pressure. So, as we know, if we insert the piezometer at the bottom, so the pressure head at this point, it will be Z1 and pore water pressure at from this point to this, it will be Z2. Like as you can see in this figure, द पोर वाटर प्रेशर फ्रॉम दिस साइड टू दिस इट इज जेड वन एंड फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस इट इज जेड टू. सो बेसिकली द टोटल पिजोमेट्रिक और द पोर वाटर हेड एट द बॉटम ऑफ अ सैंपल इट मीन्स एट दिस पॉइंट इट इज जेड वन प्लस जेड टू प्लस एच इज नथिंग बट द हाइट ऑफ अ वॉटर इट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द दीज टू कंटेनर्स. ओके सो देयर फोर द पोर वॉटर प्रेशर विच इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय यू सी ओके एट द बॉटम ऑफ द सैंपल इज गिवन बाय यू सी इज इक्वल टू जेड वन प्लस जेड टू प्लस एच इन टू गैमा डब्ल्यू. दिस गैमा डब्ल्यू इज नथिंग बट यूनिट वेट ऑफ अ वॉटर. So we can calculate the total pressure which is act at the bottom of the sample is sigma c. Sigma c which is equal to z1 plus z2 into gamma w unit weight of a water. Because the water present in z1 and z2 zone, correct? Plus z1 into gamma b. This gamma b is nothing but bulk unit weight of a soil. Okay, as we know in container b there is a presence of a soil sample and a water. So this is only for z1 into gamma b. This is only for the soil sample. So we know the total pressure head and we know the pore water pressure, so we can easily calculate the effective pressure at the bottom of a soil. That is given by sigma c dash, which is equal to total pressure head minus uc, that is pore water pressure. So we put the value of total head and pore water pressure in this formula, and after simplifying it we will get z1 into gamma b minus h into gamma w. Okay, so the output will be like this. In place of h we can write it as I into z. Why? Because as we know the hydraulic gradient which is represented by I equal to head loss divided by z, length of a soil sample. So I will be equal to h by z. So in place of h we can write it as I into z. So this is the formula of effective pressure. So from the previous equation we can generate a general equation for the effective pressure at any depth z, which is given by sigma z dash, which is equal to gamma b into z minus I z gamma w. I hope you remember this gamma z, gamma w is nothing but unit weight of a water, and this gamma b is nothing but bulk unit weight. Okay, so these indicate that there is a decrease in the effective pressure due to the upward flow of a water at any depth z. Z gamma b is the pressure of a submerged unit weight of a soil which acts in the downward direction, and I z gamma b is the seepage pressure which acts in the upward. So the effective pressure becomes zero because of the seepage pressure and because of the submerged unit weight of a soil, it will get balance and ultimately the effective pressure becomes zero, like this. After that, this, when it is equal to zero, in that condition the hydraulic gradient becomes equal to critical hydraulic gradient, which is nothing but it is the ratio of bulk unit weight to the unit weight of a water, gamma b by gamma w. Okay, so the critical hydraulic gradient, it can be written as g minus 1 divided by 1 plus e. इट इंडिकेट्स दैट द इफेक्टिव प्रेशर रिड्यूसेस टू जीरो व्हेन द हाइड्रोलिक ग्रेडियंट अटेन्स इट्स मैक्सिमम वैल्यू विच इज इक्वल टू द रेशियो ऑफ सबमर्ज यूनिट वेट ऑफ अ सॉइल एंड द यूनिट वेट ऑफ अ वॉटर. सो दिस ग्रेडियंट इज नोन एज द क्रिटिकल हाइड्रोलिक ग्रेडियंट. When the effective stresses becomes equal to zero, in that condition, the hydraulic gradient will become equal to critical hydraulic gradient, which is nothing but G minus 1 upon 1 plus E. E is nothing but void ratio. So, as you can see in this picture, this is the deep water and quicksand zone where there is no swimming is allowed. Okay. In such cases, the cohesionless soil loses all its strength and the bearing capacity. And because of this, a violent agitation of a soil grain is observed. Okay, so this is the condition of quicksand. There is no possibility of swimming. Because, see, as you can see in this picture, quicksand cannot support the weight of a man or an animal, and it behaves like a liquid with a unit weight about twice that of a water. A person can easily float in it with about one third of his body out of the quicksand. Why quicksand condition not occur in cohesive soil and in gravel soil? You just have to remember that the quicksand condition always occurred in cohesionless soil, not in cohesive soil. So, why it is so? Basically, in clays, the shear strength of a soil does not get reduced to zero, even when the effective stresses becomes equal to zero, because it is cohesive in nature. Hence, the quicksand condition does not occur in clays. As the pressure of the escaping water exerts the weight of the soil and the grains are forced apart, in that condition, the result is that the sand has no capacity, no capability to support the load, because the soil particle leaves its soil mass and it flows along with the water. But when we are talking about the pebbles or the gravels, in that condition, the pebbles or gravelly soil cannot have the quicksand because it has to exist the self weight than those of escaping water weights. So basically, in pebbles or gravels or in cohesive soils, the quicksand condition cannot occur. So, this is the end of quicksand condition. Quicksand condition is very important topic because as an interview point of view. Okay, thank you.